All right, so we're back. Let's go ahead and play. So where we left off is we just built a hangar, and we're starting to get baggage set up. Now, we do have a baggage car now, and about $45,000. We are still pretty close to a low number, like a low amount of money. Oof. That maintenance is costing us. Alright, so now that we have somewhat of a working baggage, we're probably going to readjust this baggage claim and line it up with the maintenance room. So let's see about how much that's going to cost us. 32,000. We should be able to get that. So we'll go ahead and wait for maybe a couple planes. It should be starting here soon. I have no idea Oh, shiza. I didn't think that through. We got people all on the outside of the airport. And they're getting angry. Was definitely not thought through. Oh. I forgot one thing. I forgot to look at what way. The conveyor belts came out underneath. So, that should give us what we need, and we're going to come here with a small foundation. All right, we're gonna hold off on that foundation. Because we're gonna need some money to do what we need to do. And I am not wanting to take out a loan. I don't know why we just have random baggage sitting here. All right, so with flights, let's go ahead and bring in a Ford Air. And while we're thinking about it, a large gate. In order to upgrade our terminals to large, we're gonna need to do the second floor, so That's gonna take a little bit of time. But the good news with having a second floor is we'll be able to eventually expand security. And in an essence, turn this first floor into security. Then once we get into offices, I believe I have a yeah, I have a third floor, so offices and stuff like that will be on the third floor. So, in order to hit these operational goals, we are gonna need to get this baggage claim functional. And then we will start increasing the number of flights we see. So, this is what is needed to get us fully functional baggage claim. Looks good. And flights. Kind of stuck on that for the moment being. So, eventually we will get the foundation going for the second floor and upgrade these gates. But first of all, let's go ahead and increase our passenger throughput. So, hopefully by adding this extra ID check, we can start increasing the number of people we actually have at the scanners. And it looks like we can handle dual gates. And our operational seems to be going really good. All right. So let's go ahead and start looking at about how much this foundation is going to cost us. Whew. All right, so 2 to 5% on our loan interest if we go that route. So, I really want to hold off on doing any loans. But I can't upgrade any of our gates. That's why we have that money. Wait, can we? That re still requires that. So, with 100,000, we can. Oh man, yeah. We can't do much. And if we take out a loan, we're gonna be forced to pay that back. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. So we're gonna apply for a $700,000 loan. It just killed our credit rating, but it's going to allow us to build our second floor foundation. But with this, we can upgrade the size of our terminals. We'll actually upgrade the size of our gates. So, we're just gonna watch this construction. With this upper floor, we'll be able to pull in two more gates. Even though I kind of want to hold off on putting gates on this side. While we're at it, we'll go ahead and start working on technology. That should give us some of what we need to get remote scanners and stuff. Save some money on security. Yeah, they're complaining about the environment. But there's not much we can do about that just yet. We may want to come in and adjust our flights. I'm not sure yet. We should be able to dismantle a gate without having to get rid of the flights. If not, we're gonna have to get a little creative with this. Alright, so our construction's coming along. We may have to look at a few things though here. In ops. So, we're gonna want Another ticketing desk. And increase our ticketing just a little bit. The goal will be to get people through as quickly as possible. Alright, how is... Almost done. And then, throughout the night, we'll go ahead and work on the gates. And that should increase our transit capacity. Alright, so I know. You're arguing. But we're doing this just temporarily so we can clear up space on our gates. I'm gonna go ahead and pause it here for now. normally this is not something we want to do, but I currently don't have the ability to create another gate at the moment. And we are going to have a really bad time with our operational for this one day. So, we're definitely in a world of hurt here. Now, our flights, we're going to go ahead and move up to the new gate. For now, we're going to do that. Until we can make a better suited stairwell. This is just the chaos of moving gates over. Then, once our 10 p.m. plane leaves, we'll go ahead and dismantle and reassemble the new gate.
Alright, so now we can move our flight statuses back to a normal. Hours each. Alright, so now we got the gates all normal. We can come in here and start working on how we want this to look. So, I'm going to go ahead and dismantle this staircase. And once that's made, we're gonna dismantle this one. And put it here. That'll give us enough space. We are going to come here and We're gonna give them some decent seating. Put a garbage bin there. And expand queues. So now, do it that way. Let's look at what the foundation here costs. So we are now gonna have to work on paying back the loan. Most of this bottom area I might make into like a cafe or something for now. But we are gonna have to start making some money. So, this will probably be a good spot to go ahead and call it a day. Next episode is probably just going to be finishing off this foundation and slowly paying back our loan while working on bringing that third gate online. So, see you guys on the next episode.